banned out the position for support of Empire. I'm not sure how to pronounce his name.
Miposhka.
Is it Miposhka?
Yeah.
They're targeting Miposhka right from the start.
I'm telling you guys, Empire, the key to beating them is controlling Miposhka and King R. They are so dynamic as a team when those supports are moving around the map making things happen.
I agree completely. He has been in the spotlight many, many times.
Yeah, a Dazzle first pick from Secret. We haven't seen too many of those, but...
It might lead to a Huskar later, yeah. Because Secret actually has a history of running Huskar.
Yeah. But Empire are going to see that.
Kind of a pocket strategy.
Empire are going to see that. Second phase.
Hopefully.
For their sake.
Yeah, for their sake.
Black's already worried. He's like...
Watermelon okay. Man.
And this is something... This is really what they started going to at Shanghai. When they were playing, they were struggling a little bit, not necessarily the same extent, but coming into that tournament, they went to the Tide Enigma combo early on in the group stage, really refocused on around those teams, that team play, those team fights.
I love the Disruptor pickup right after because he actually counts as Tidehunter. If you put him in a kinetic field and put your ult on top of him, even though he has his OP passive, it is really OP, by the way.
OP passive?
It's a super OP Kraken Shell, man.
No, but Static Storm applies the silence continuously.
Exactly. Yeah,
right?
He won't be able to Ravage.
Right, and Empire, by the way, seeing how successful VGR were with this open in the last game.
Right. Although they have the Dazzle to already counteract that, because he can probably just Grave him, and then he has 5 seconds to get Ravage up anyway. It's gonna be like, who's out of position, who's not.
Come on, Winter, you're my clutch ace in the hole here when it comes to calling these drafts. What are you seeing, man?
I'm thinking what Secret is trying to do, like what type of system they're trying to run, because they're going back to the old system where they open drafts with Dazzle. And we've been always talking about Secret, their recent problems has been always the lack of farm distribution, like the way they distribute the farm. So I'm curious to see if they're actually going to just focus more on the tree cores, put all the farm on the tree cores and play too poor support, because the past 2 months they've been playing on Puppy and like jungling and much more greedy support. So is the Dazzle opening going to mean that they're actually going to just put way less farm on both of their supports and just put all the farm on the tree cores?
I would love for Secret to go back to the Slark. You and I spoke about this, Alan. Slark has been a staple hero of Eternal Envy in their Shanghai success. And like the bans indicated could be a Slark. Darkseer and Axe both are very, very strong against Slark.
I see the two heroes that I talked about that I want to see Envy play in a BO1 are Slark or Drow. I feel like those were his two strongest heroes and the two heroes that they played around best as a team in Shanghai.
It might be just
it might be a draw. We have a
rush lineup. The Dire, Dazzle, Venge, and they have
or
a big ultimate.
Are they going Invoker?
On Secret?
Nothing against Arteezy, but I don't think his Invoker is like super sharp right now.
It's been... He's had a couple of really good games on it recently. They just haven't played well around.
He's won 3 out of 5.
Right.
So
I just think the problem with Arteezy and Walker is he farms really late. He gets into late game, which is the problem of the hero getting there. But I just feel in late game he doesn't have enough experience to use the spells properly as people like we would, for example, who played like a ton of games on the hero.
But I'm not going to let him have the DP, that's for sure. So that's gone.
But there's still a lot of heroes that can use the Roshan right now. There's Ursa, there's Lycan.
I mean, with Venge, pretty much all heroes can do an easy Roche, though.
Basically, that's what we see right now, how they are building their lineup.
Right.
They have two supports that help Roche, very good in the lane. They have a big AoE control that helps when you are being contested at the Roshan, so it deters the opponent from trying to fight you at the Roshan.
What is also really good, we spoke about the kinetic field and Disruptor ult on Tide. Now they actually have two measures against it. They can either swap him out or Grave him, and that's going to lead to a really good Ravage, usually. Because most people are going to clump around him, they're going to punch him, you know, try to kill him as fast as possible. You stop that, you ravage them, you win a team fight.
So I think most likely they're just going to go for calls that are going to take up a lot of space because they have two supports right now that basically don't need much farm. They need some experience.
Right.
And they're going to just do their job just fine. They don't need farm at all. So that is the direction I can see Secret taking this.
Then Slark would be a really good hero for that. Because Drow is more team-oriented, and Tidehunter is typically not the best Drow hero, because obviously he's melee.
But it does help with the overall threat, right?
He does have with the weaknesses too.
You get a mech and you group up and you push with Drow,
right?
Tide.
But that's the big issue that most Drow lineups have to address is they have to find some way to initiate.
Right.
Tidehunter solves that. He's relatively autonomous in the offlane.
Right.
Or you don't have to initiate, because you just have to siege the tower. You right. force the enemy to jump onto you, and you're getting an early mech on the tide, and you're just waiting for them to come on. You pop your mech and you pop your ravage to counter initiate. You don't have to make the first move because you're sieging.
I mean, they're obviously thinking hard. They've already used 2 minutes of the bonus time in this pick.
Yeah, because this is the junction where they should decide whether they are going to build a rush strat,
right?
Or they're going to go for a very early game strat, or they're going to go for late
Phantom
game.
Lancer.
Wow. Bring out the PL.
I actually think DK is one of the better heroes against the PL lineup
it's
in general.
Pretty good versus Lifestealer though.
That is true, but if a Lifestealer ever gets Mjolnir, then PL is not that big of a problem.
Yeah, and that's part of why the current Lifestealer is so hard to address, is that he has a lot of freedom in terms of his item builds. And once he gets that armlet up, he's fairly free in terms of what he builds next.
We spoke about it as well. If they ever get the initiation on the PL with an infested Nakes, for example, in the Dragon Knight,
right.
the PL, he's going to be very, very low HP, and his illusions will just die instantly. As soon as they spawn, they will die.
Even more silence Whoa. For the Tide.
Yeah, okay. With Ricky.
Basically, what's going to happen is the Ricky is going to try to find the Dazzle and the Venge in teamfights. They're going to focus on...
To get infested with the Nakes.
Yeah, the target in front, and the Ricky is going to try and eliminate the Dazzle or the Venge.
Right. Or at least silence them in critical moments.
Yeah. So we see a very clear game plan about how Empire is going to approach the team fights, what they're going to be attempting to do. And it looks really promising of the strategy that they want to deal with the Dazzle and the Venge.
It feels like it's very hard to execute against Venge and Dazzle.
Yes.
Like, their lineup is definitely way harder to execute.
We totally forgot about Beastmaster.
Yeah, and they didn't.
Nobody picked Beast so far.
And Bounty Hunter too, 7-0 yeah. coming into today, yeah. getting through these drafts.
Yeah. Cool.
That's a really good ban, by the way.
Okay.
Yep, that's to protect the Lifestealer and the DK. And like I mentioned, I think Secret are going to gear up towards a tri-core. Three heroes, they're going
to
farm a lot.
I mean, Secret probably has to go back to an Invoker now. Yeah. Unless yeah. they're... Oh yeah, I never mind, they just banned Razor. But usually, I think they would prefer Razor right now because it's one of Arteez's premier heroes as well.
Yeah, DP and Razor really, he brought into the meta a couple patches ago by really showing the farming potential of
right.
those heroes.
Right. But right now, what do we have left? It's pretty much just Invoker.
Yeah, but for Empire, they're going to look to pick up their offlane, their
yeah,
initiating
right.
hero.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, there's still a bad rider. There's still a bad rider yeah. if they wanted that, but it's not that good against...
There's Venge, though.
They already have Venge. They have Tide Hunter as well. Beastmaster's banned.
I mean, there's Prophet, but...
There's Prophet, but...
Doesn't feel like it synergizes well with their lineup.
That's true.
Something Afterlife plays a lot.
I guess you could Nightstalker.
I mean, then again, Bad Rider is never bad with a Lifestealer, though. You can actually get the initiation going, and...
I mean, Slarger is still there.
Or Sand King.
Oh, but that's really good versus the illusions, though.
Oh, we spoke about it the other day.
Yeah,
if you get
Aghanims, right?
Yeah, right.
Yes.
If you get Aghanims,
yeah,
then the whole PL he just explodes. Right. All his illusions and the hero, he just explodes instantly.
Yeah.
This is actually
exactly,
hard.
Exactly the conversation
yeah.
you and I had.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, but the only issue is how is this hero gonna get towards his bling, because his farming abilities in the jungle right now is really, really bad. He farms very slow in the jungle, so he has to somehow. Very good landing
okay.
phase.
So Gong Frey, slightly safer. Jara, quickly
this
then.
This is Arteez PL mid.
Yep.
Looks like it.
And Envy's going to use Jara.
Not that good.
Okay. We're going to go down the line. I'm going to start with Black this time. Now, these are predictions post-draft. I've given you a bit of a chance here. Where are we going? Very quickly.
I really like Empire. I'm going for Empire.
Okay.
I like Empire too, even though I was advised not to follow Black, but I'm still
wow.
going to follow Black.
Okay.
I have to confirm Empire. This is just so in their comfort zone right now.
Wow. Three Empire.
I
can't
four.
Believe it.
Three Empire. Okay.
I'm 2-4. I just want to say it.
Right. Okay.
We all were wrong the last game.
They've all gone the same way. Who would have thought it? Let's head over to our commentary team now for the final game of the day. Team Secret versus Team Empire.
Thank you very much, Red Eye. Indeed, I'm OD Pixel. I'm going to be joined by Ben. Ben, are you ready for Secret versus Empire? Can I just say, is the crowd ready for Secret versus Empire? Thank you. Well, without any further ado, let's get ourselves into the action then. Here we go. And here we have it indeed, ladies and gentlemen, the final best of one of the day. Let's go for a quick rundown to the heroes and the boys. Afterlife, Ramses, the talented kid. He's had a lot of hype built around him. We'll see if it stands up now against Secret. Scandal is back. He's been around for years, the man, and he's been able to drive this team of a mixture of new and old talent that's done incredibly well at recent performances. Secret, though, Ben, these guys, they've got a lot of hype around them. They're yet to turn up, really, at this LAN. Are they going to turn up now, Ben?
I say they have a lot of good heroes for Empire. They've been first picking the Disruptor a lot. They have a lot of silences to deal with the Tidehunter. They have the Sand King to deal with the Phantom Lancer. I must favor Empire's draft over Team Secret's. Early in the game, Puppy did TP and try and drop some Observer Wards deep in the Empire jungle. However, he was scattered out by Ramses and was not able to plop any eyes down.
All right, well, as we get this one started, we'll see who's going to be able to grab the two runes. It looks like top, Ricky. He might go for a little bit of a cheeky steal. We'll see if he gets away with this one. Well, we see it. Oh, he does as well. Meposhka taking the bounty rune there away from Artur. So Empire starting off with both of the bounty runes here in the laning stage. And talking about lanes, Ben, looks like we're going to be seeing, in fact, Envy heading down to the bottom lane on the Gyrocopter. So who's dodging who here?
Sand King is a very good matchup versus the Phantom Lancer, but Phantom Lancer is mid.
Uh-huh.
I think the Sand King wins this Tidehunter matchup.
We'll see indeed how the mid lane does go now with Artz on his PL against Scandal on the DK, throwing the Lance through. And it's going to be really interesting to see as well how this bottom lane pans out. Envy being backed up by Pylodire and the Venge, going head-to-head against the dual lane of Empire with both Ramses on the Lifesteal and the backup, of course, from the Disrupt. I mean, on this bottom lane, do you feel that this is Secret's favorable lane? Envy should be able to find the majority of farm?
As long as the Riki doesn't cause too much havoc. He was parked in between the mid T1 and the T2 waiting for the chicken.
Oh, look at this. Puppy's come down as well. And Secret, maybe thinking about a bit of action, but no, Pi still level 1, just with the Terra. Envy, just coming in with the pause here. Hopefully it's going to be something pretty brief as we can get our way on with this one. But all things said and done, do you feel that for the side of Secret or Empire, you know, Secret putting this pressure on the bottom lane, it's obviously going to mean it's unlikely that King R can leave the lane, head towards mid to help out. Is that all right for Empire, or should the DK be fine anyway against a PL?
The DK should definitely be fine versus the PL. In terms of the bottom lane, I think this is something that we saw Alliance do with their Rubick, Slardar, Dazzle tri-lane to try and pressure the Lifestealer, and I think it was versus Liquid that they had a lot of success. Lifestealer died maybe 4 times in the laning phase in the first 10 minutes.
I mean, what can we see Secret try and achieve as well with this lane? I mean, is it enough just to stop the Lifestealer farming, or do you need to be finding kills with this aggressive tri lane as well?
I think it's enough to stop him from farming. Okay. Also, Disruptor is very, very weak in the early game. You should be getting kills. I think if you don't get any kills, it's not worth it.
Okay, and as you said, of course, on the top lane, having that Sand King versus Tide 1v1 matchup. I mean, talk to me more about that. I mean, is this a matchup that's going to be fairly even, or do you see there being a quick, kind of clear winner in this lane?
Sand King should almost always win any matchup versus a melee in a one-on-one situation. He should not be really too scared of anyone moving around. I guess maybe the Riki, but if Riki shows himself on bottom, they're going to be A-OK. They do have an Observer and a Sentry, so they do see Meposhka right now. So he can play like a real 1v1 instead of having to be like, is there a Riki here? He could carry a TP score if he really were that scared, though.
Absolutely. And of course, we can see as well from Secret, they do have a Sentry as well down actually in the lane on the bottom. So they know exactly when Meposhka comes in. Yeah, looks like we're ready to get ourselves back on with the action. And we'll indeed see what happens here, because obviously, as you pointed out, Meposhka is making the movement down towards the bottom. But it will, of course, all be spotted out here by the side of Secret. And here we have back into this one. As we can see so far, it's early days, but CS-wise, 4-0 on Envy. Ramses is indeed managing to keep toe-and-toe, 4-0 at the moment. So the Lifestealer not having too much of a hard time against the Gyrocopter. And mid lane, Artur versus Scandal, 3-3 against the 3-3. So again, a very, very even lane. I mean, even the top lane is not much different at the moment in the first wave. So I guess it's going to be down to these rotations, down to what Meposhka can do. We can see at the moment he is hanging around between the tier 1 and the tier 2, maybe to see if he can get away with a courier snipe. And we'll see indeed if that is going to come out anytime soon here, but Artzy looks to be a bit of got away. Okay, he's going to actually just get the Quelling Blade sent out. So this point, Artzy may be at the risk of losing his item and the courier. Bottom lane, a bit of aggression from Secret though, as they're eyeing up King R, bringing him low with a Rocket Barrage. King R will be able to make the distance, and oh, let's have a look at mid lane. Oh, Secret's courier. They could be the first to die this game. Aposhka won, give it a second, and that is the courier down. Aposhka getting away with that one, and Secret, even though they don't see the Ricky on the map, they don't play around the fact that he could be looking for the snipe.
Actually, Pilot, I did draw an arrow of Ricky's exact route where he was going to head in between the mid T1 and the T2, so Secret supports cannot be very happy about that one. It's pretty hard to play around a Ricky. Bounty Hunter, he's somewhat limited by mana, even if he does have clarity, but Ricky, he could be anywhere.
Talking about Ricky, he's actually headed up towards the top lane, Universe. Zuri, of course. Fairly tanky, very hard for the two of them to get away with killing him as such. And in terms of the CS, he's not had too much trouble against the Caustic Finale. 12 for 2. At the moment, standing pretty close to the farm of Afterlife on his Sand King. But bottom lane, as we can see, that is where kind of the big difference in farm is being created. Ramzes is certainly struggling now against this aggressive tri lane of Secret, and Envy is breaking away. I mean, if you're Empire, you've got this Lifestealer that is struggling. How do you resolve the situation early on?
It's okay for a Lifestealer to get sacked. He used to get sacked when he was very, very popular just because he doesn't really die in teamfights that often. He can neutral very easily with Feast, so he's not that big of a liability if he's underfarmed. And you can always just hop in someone like the Ricky, like we saw earlier today, to catch up in experience and levels. No problem.
And we can see as well a bit of a rotation movement from the Disruptor on the side of Empire, obviously leaving Ramzes on his own, but as you said, maybe Empire just realizing that they're going to need to sack that position. And just coming out with a fortification to try and buy some time, because Secret, they're putting a lot of pressure on this bottom tower. Ramzes, he's trying to hide. They have found him out. Not going to go for the magic missile, of course. Ramzes, he's got the rage, so pretty hard for Secret to catch out unless he is massively out of position on the Lifestealer. Ramzes in the moment just trying to soak up as much XP as he can. And Secret, they will be able to take a very, very early on tier 1 here, so more gold in their pockets, and Envy's of course going to be very happy with this start. And it'll be interesting to see just how active of a gyrocopter he plays. Mid lane, Arteezy in trouble, he's going to get Dragon Tail stunned out. He's in the cloud, and one more touch, and that's your first blood. Miposhka pulling it out there with the Ricky rotations, and Arteezy just not expecting it at all, man.
It's a very smart, patient maneuver by Ricky. He waited until 4.5 minutes. Sentries only last 4 minutes, so generally they drop it right around when the creep spawn or shortly after the first rune spawns. So it's about time that they would expire, and he knew that Puppy had 3 sentry wards on him, so they were super unlikely to have dropped a sentry ward there.
Let's see top lane. King Art having eyes onto Universe. Also interesting to know that King Art yet to skill, so really just waiting to see what the opportune
skills
will be.
There's no epicenter yet. So this is not really that opportune of a kill for them. Perhaps with Miposhka.
Maybe
there.
Yeah, maybe with the Ricky as well. But as you said, I mean, SK is just half a level away from having the experience for the epicenter.
Maybe Universe realizes that Ricky's around here, yeah, because he's not yet level 6.
And it's going to be a hard gank as well now with Universe himself just about to hit level 6. Bottom lane, going to be seeing a bit of action onto Ramzes. He's got the rage. We'll see if they're able to buy the time to get the magic missile. But a smart move from Ramzes here, just slowing down Pi with the open wounds. So no chance of the Venge catching up to get the stun following through after the duration of the rage.
And Secret got what they came for. They are limiting the Lifestealer's farm as well as taking down the T1 early. Not so important for the Roche, but more for the Ancients. They can get Tidehunter's early blink by farming the Ancients, or just get Gyro nice and big. PL can also do the Ancients very early on.
Now we can see, actually towards the mid lane, both mid laners are going to head down towards the bottom room. I'll see if anything kicks off there. Bottom lane still. Ramzes, he's feeling a bit more safe now. He has got King R around, and in fact they're going to go for some action. A beautiful glimpse, bringing Envy back under the tower. The TP's come through Afterlife with a Burrow Strike onto 2. Envy, he's falling low and he's gone. They've found themselves one kill. Can they get themselves anything else? Ramzes and Miposhka chasing down Puppy with the open wounds. They should be able to get this one. Puppy just graves himself, tries to turn. Arteezy is coming in with a rotation. Can Secret do anything about this action? It doesn't look like they can. They've lost a second hero, Secret. An Empire just playing very nicely, and just the sneakiness of that Disruptor waiting for the perfect timing to get that glimpse on Envy, bringing him right under the tier 2.
Yeah, very good kill for them. Important.
Yeah, 3-0 now.
And buys a lot of time for Universe. That's not really a matchup that you want to stay there for too long. Sand King still holding his skill point at 6, not yet maxing Caustic or putting a point in Sandstorm or Epicenter.
Yeah, but as you said, obviously, the plus for Secret here being that Universe, he is going to get that recent kind of decent timing on the mechanism. And then if he's able to get himself involved in the fights, there's a lot of team fight potential. Just hitting a Ravage, allowing Envy to get out the following cooldown and chase down some of the heroes. And Envy, in fact, he's actually going to head up towards this top lane. So he will be now in the realms of both Puppy and Universe if anything kicks off. But Empire looks like they've got more interest in trying to kick something off in the mid lane. Miposhka hanging around with Scandal. So Scandal feels that he can find an opening to and allow the follow through. They've also got Disruptor as well. King R is in the neighborhood, so a lot of catch potential to deal with this PL. But it looks like really most action going on the top, where Secret now is a four-man, just looking to keep getting the objectives. We're coming up to the eight-minute mark. They're already looking to take down their second tier one away from the side of Empire. And it looks like they're going to get away with it, Ben. So even though they may not have the kills, they're getting the tower goal.
Ravage is extremely strong at this point in the game, especially with the supports on Empire being very low level. There's not a good way to stop it. Level 2 smokescreen, not going to be enough. No static storm up yet on Disruptor, and no epicenter to burst him down early. And no blink. I'm surprised there's not more stacking coming out from either team. But Secret doing a good job of making Empire reluctant to make any moves.
I'm in Poshka. Is coming into Secret's jungle, just getting a bit of intel, spotting out what's going on. Eyes onto Pylodi at the moment, and the rest of Empire is now beginning to converge in up towards this area of the jungle, so we may see something kick off. A bit of a wraparound from the DK, he does have a DD available. And the Poshka just keeping eyes onto Puppy. Here he comes, Scandal, DD in the bottle, ready to go out of dragon form, and here we have it, a couple of hits and a strike, Puppy's down. They get themselves a 4-1 on the board now, Empire and Secret. They don't seem to have an answer for this one. We've got Envy hiding in the trees, in fact just TPing away from the whole engagement towards the mid lane. And Secret at the moment just avoiding fights from Empire.
They're doing a good job of not fighting around the tide Empire is. They're taking down a lot of T1s on the side of Secret, but the downside is that they have so much more area to cover with Sentry Wards. The supports just can't keep everyone safe, and they can farm more area, but this also just leaves way more room for the Riki to run around and wreak havoc on Secret, already with phase boost just scouting out any weak heroes. And we see one sentry dropped in mid for our tour.
Universe level 9, doing very well indeed in the progress towards that mechanism. But mid lane, Miposhka again, I mean the man that's really been causing a huge amount of havoc for the side of Secret. He's 2-0-1 on the Riki at the moment. So making a lot of action happy. And eyes onto Buppy. Scandal is also around, but at the same time, Puppy, he's got teammates, he has got backup, and they do know that Miposhka's here. So Puppy trying to play kind of the fool here, see if Miposhka gets baited to hang around, but Miposhka realizes something's up, and he'll back himself away. But we've got the 10-minute mechanism now online for Universe, so we'll see if Secret want to try and get something done with that one. Ramzes, he's closing in on the armlet.
And the Riki also scouts out that they have no dust on Secret, just a couple of sentries, which is very easy for the Riki to avoid. If he's near an ally or even a neutral creep, he can just blink strike away, yeah. And Secret just wastes a lot of their time. And he knows where this Puppy placed that sentry.
Now we can see now, of course, though 10 minutes Universe, yes, he may have that mechanism, but you look towards Afterlife and he's got the blink dagger done. So Secret, they've got to be very, very aware of the movements of Empire. And Empire smoking up, moving into the jungle. They found out Envy, and Envy immediately getting caught out. They'll lay down the Static Storm as well. And Empire, they'll find one of the questions. Can they find anything else? Secret turning around the Ravage. Coming out, it's only going to connect onto 2, but it will kill King R. Can they get Scandal as well? A nice heal bomb coming out from Puppy. But the chase is not going to be available because Afterlife coming in with the epicenter. The Burrow Strike as well. Universe will pop the mechanism. Afterlife incredibly low. The heal bomb again. Afterlife, can he get himself out of it with the stick charges? He may just survive. Wave of Terror is not going to be enough. Secret, eyes onto Miposhka. Have they got the detective of the man if the invis kicks back in? They've laid down a sentry. Miposhka right on the edge. He's actually come back under it. Maybe see if he realizes that he's out of vision, and I think he will. No, again, the sentry. Oh, jumps down Miposhka with the plays, just avoiding Secret. So, I mean, Secret, I do get one in return, but again, losing the core like that, that was a fight with a Ravage and a Mechanism. It just feels like it's not good enough for Secret at this point of the game.
Definitely not, and Ramzes did a very good job of backing out. They have so many ways to deal with his rage. A lot of minus armor, a lot of damage coming out, even the Anchor Smash to limit his damage output, Phantom Lancer can kite him endlessly. So that was the call for Empire. If he had stayed a little bit longer, Empire would have kind of been forced to hang around, keep him alive. But he did a good job. He knows that he's under farm. He just needs some more time to catch back up. I mean, more importantly, he needs to not die.
Bottom lane. Eyes onto Ramzes. Universe is coming as well. He's going to try for this one, but Ramzes got the back of a King R. The kinetic field getting laid down, and Ramzes, he just rages and starts to chomp away. Every tries for the CP is not going to be successful. And another death there for the gyrocopter. Arteezy's coming. Maybe see if he can get a bit of a cleanup job done, but he's not going to be able to chase. And again, they're losing Envy like this, and Secret unable to find anything in return that time.
Yeah, not too many fighting builds or items coming out from them. See, no points in Poison Touch from Dazzle, no points in Homing Missile, not even Max Rocket Barrage coming out from Gyrocopter, and no points in Phantom Rush on Phantom Lancer. So they just have an extremely difficult time chasing, especially with no Blink Dagger up on Tidehunter, opting for that teamfight build instead with the mech. So maybe once they get level 6 on Ventral Spirit, they can get some more kills. I see the Tome flying out to Pilot Eye, but that will only get them level 5.5.
We'll see if Empire's well want to look for a bit more action as Afterlife does have Epicenter coming back off cooldown in 10 seconds. We can see already Empire. They certainly look ready to go. Grouped up as four towards the mid. Secret will be ready to form some kind of a defense. Universe will have the Ravage back in five. Envy and Pi in the sidelines. See if they want to make a go. Eyes onto Scanner. They're leading with the Spirit Lance from Arteezy. There's the follow-up stun. Envy looking for the cooldown, but again, the Static Storm's laid out. Ravage will come through. They should be able to get Scanner. They will. They'll also take down the Disrupt on the sidelines. Ramzes raging up, trying to get himself out, but Afterlife goes straight in with the Epicenter. It wasn't enough damage. It's Secret. They'll punish Empire's aggression this time to take out a fourth. And that was the exact fight that Secret needed to bring themselves back into a game where they were struggling early on in these early kind of rotations that Empire were catching them off guard with every time.
That was fantastic positioning by Universe, skirting outside the kinetic field and the static storm, and anyone that helped DK was going to die. He also managed to catch Lifestealer before he raged.
A big mess up there for Empire and Secret. Quick to punish.
Yep. Nice swap by Pilot Eye.
It really was. Yeah, I mean, Envy looked to be on the verge of dying there, but indeed the team playing around him very nicely. I mean, interesting was, look at the net worth. Because of this action universe, he's the richest man in the game. He's got 6.3k at the moment on his Tidehunter.
Yep. And before that fight started, they had pinged out the Riki on the top lane. He was level 5, trying to get level 6, but no way for him to easily get to that mid tower. And Secret feeling very confident in that 4-on-5. They had also committed a lot of sentries. There were 3 around where Arteezy is right now and 2 in that mid lane. No way they could have get jumped by Riki over there.
It's going to be interesting to see what Universe wants to do as well with the gold saved up by. I guess in this situation, he does go for the Blink before finishing off the Greaves. Reason to get Greaves first?
I think Blink, just because the Lifestealer doesn't really feel threatened right now. There's no way to for him to pop his rage. And he can just dodge the Ventral Spirit Stun if he gets swapped. He can also dodge it, Spirit Lance, anything that they throw at him. Aside from Blink Ravage in melee range, he should be able to dodge.
I'm a posture coming in with the smoke just to get some vision out. And we'll be detected here by the scan from Secret. Poshka just going to continue to try and get some vision onto Arteezy.
Afterlife hasn't been having a big struggle keeping up in levels. I think if it were like level 2 Epicenter at that time, Universe is level 11, so he should be very, very close. But he's actually only level 8 at this point. At 9.
I mean, yeah, that was the thing. It was a good Epicenter from Afterlife. It just wasn't quite enough damage. It brought Envy incredibly low to the edge, but not just quite enough to finish him off.
And Envy will continue his trend of building a lot of strength on his Gyrocopter.
Look at this, they might find Arteezy and the jungle on his own. Empire closing in on the PL. See if they can punish this one, and indeed they can. Jumping in, no messing around with the Epicenter, trick to the trade as well. And that's the PL out of the game for 40 seconds. Punishing Death Timer here for the man, and Empire will look to get a bit of pressure onto the tier 2. I mean, Secret, they just can't afford to lose the course like this, surely, man.
Well, if he spends his gold, it's okay, but unfortunately, he did not go for a farming build. No BOTs on him, opting for the Defusal, knowing that they have stronger team fight with the Tidehunter, and the Riki can generally catch him out split pushing, especially with a DK, Disruptor, pretty much anyone on their team to follow up on a smoke cloud.
And Universe indeed did get that Blink online, so Ravage is back available. Empire still just cause waiting for the Epicenter, we'd imagine, before they want to try and go for a big kind of group up, especially when they know that they're going to be fighting into this pretty impressive powerhouse from the side of Secret now that the Universe is just reaching this kind of insane point of the game. We look back over towards Afterlife, and he is of course going for that build where he gets the Axe straight after the Blink Dagger. Point Booster is in his inventory.
I wonder if Secret's going to go for Roche now that they know Epicenter's down. They did lose Arteezy, but at least they can get something out of it. if they try and fight around there. It's going to be difficult, though, with the Disruptor, Static Storm, and perhaps Riki scouting out. They do have a Sentry and an Obs outside the pit, but it's going to expire in 1 minute time.
I see. Undo what the action is. Four heroes around the pit at the moment for Secret.
And Puppy has gone for the Medallion first build. Very popular build for him on the Dazzle. So I think they can do it. Level 4 Wave of Terror plus Medallion should make pretty quick work.
Oh, and this, the scan is still... Oh, that's perfect timing there, really, for Secret if they want to go for the Roche. Empire used the scan just outside the pit, but it runs out just as Secret move in with the smoke. So Empire, unlikely to realize that this is going on as Secret. They should get away with that. I mean, that was literally just as the scan wore out. Secret with a huge stroke of luck there, really.
They'd still have to walk into Ravage, even if they knew they were in there. So I at this point, they definitely know that they're in there, but they can't do anything about it. No epicenter up, cooling down in 5. That was a very small window that Secret took, and good itemization, of course.
Top lane Scandal, being able to use the space as efficiently as you can, and we'll take down the tier 2 away from Secret. Actually continuing to hang around. I mean, this ward is going to spot out anyone that's going to come and try and look to move towards him.
In a highly contested point in the earlier Riki vs DK game was that Fada did not end up building a BKB on the Dragon Knight. And Scandal will not opt for that same item build, instead going for the BKB immediately after the armlet, which I think is a very good choice versus the Tide. Here he has the armor to deal with the Weave, the Wave of Terror, and the Medallion.
I mean, looking at the two lineups as well, Ben, I mean, as this game goes on, are Secret kind of comfortable taking this one late? I mean, is there any reason for them to try and rush the action against Empire? Is there a risk if they don't?
I think the cores are going to have a lot of struggles. Like, the Lifestealer, I think, can do a lot of damage versus Gyrocopter. He has a lot of armor to tank flak, and Gyrocopter is not the best at handling single damage output, especially when he went for a Dragonlance HOD build, a very defensive, high HP, high armor build. And the Phantom Lancer, he has to deal with a splash from the Dragon Knight. He has to deal with a constant smoke screen, which you can't defusal off or manta off, and the AoE from the Sand King. So I think that Secret cannot feel comfortable at all going to the later game, and then the Tidehunter can get countered by BKBs from the Dragon Knight, Riki perhaps later, and of course the Raid from the Lifestealer.
Look at the Scandal as well in this top lane. This is a man that really shows no fear. He was just hanging around, you know, deep into the lane on his own, and just with the confidence that Secret wouldn't be able to deal with him. And indeed they weren't. You know, Pylodi was looking to set up some action, but the creep spotted him out, so not a chance to set up anything there. Meanwhile on the bottom lane, RTZ beginning to get a bit more space, and he's really stepped up the farm right now on top of the Diffuser Blade, 2k gold. And that will, of course, go straight into, I'd imagine, the Booster Travel. So yeah, indeed, Booster Travel and Diffuser now online for RTZ. So he's going to start to farm incredibly fast, and it's just a question of how well Empire can catch him out. But as we've seen, Empire, they have got some good heroes for catching out PL.
The Riki Lifestealer and Fest Bomb should be enough to kill anyone, maybe not the Tidehunter. He's going 4 staff to counter the smoke screen. It's also just good against the open wounds, it's good against Dragon Knight.
I mean, as we've seen, yeah, as you said, having that force, you know, it's going to be crucial for a universe to hit these Ravages. Each time that he has, it's pretty much been a team fight in favor of Secret and Secret. Talking about the boys, they are going for a smoke, moving into Empire's jungle. Empire with 3 towards the mid and 2 towards the top. It may be a hard catch. We'll see how far Empire want to move away from their tier 2. Ramses?
Oh, he just used Rage.
I was going to say,
they
yeah,
cannot
this is,
hang around that T2.
This is a good window for Secret if they can get themselves over there, but it looks like they're not too aware of the whereabouts of Empire. Maybe now, as Afterlife reveals them, so they can go for jump onto the Sand King. Let's see what the play is here. Universe jumps in, initiates with the Gush, holding onto the Ravage for the time. Beeling feels that he's not going to need it in Afterlife. One Burrow strike to escape, but the homing missile is already onto him. We get the blink off in Afterlife. Looks like he'll be able to avoid that one, so... I mean, Universe and the boys, they've got to head back, because look at the top lane. There's a bit of a heavy push coming in, and Puppy, he's actually going to be the first to tank this. And now Universe into the cloud. He's got to be careful. Scandal pops the BKB, and Universe, he'll hold onto the Ravage, of course, for this time being, but... Empire doing a significant amount of damage to the tier 3 in Secret. Coming in with RTZ as well. Let's see what they can do to punish this one. They're moving on to King Eyes. Gonna go for the TP out. He's not gonna make it. Secret will be able to kill the Disruptor. Scandal with a stun onto Envy. And Washa just dropping down the cloud. And it looks like Empire just want to get themselves the hell out of here. The Secret can pick up more. And it looks like they may do. This could be huge for them. With the cooldown, the Spirit Lance onto Scandal. They'll get the DK as well. So Secret, even though they take a fair bit of damage to their tier 3, they do manage to take 2 kills back in return.
Yeah, and maybe not some great communication coming out from Empire over there. Sun King would just narrowly escape the gank, and it was actually kind of crazy that Secret could not kill him. He was farming out creeps with no stun up, and he just kind of walked away and then stunned away after a few seconds. But Secret's damage output is very lacking at the moment if they don't have Arteezy there on top of them with the defusal charges, or if they don't blow the Ravage.
And we can see as well, really, the only here on the side of Secret that's kind of falling behind slightly is Envy. He's about a 1k or so behind that of the side of Empire. So we'll see if he's able to catch up to the cores. It's still a small window and it's still very early days. There's 22 and a half minutes in, 8%.
He needs an HOD creep to stack the Ancients. Yep. There's no creep at the Ancients right now, and he needs that to keep up his farm. Or else the Lifesteal is just going to eat him alive.
Someone else that's going to be a bit of an issue now, the fact that Miposhka, he has finished up the Diffusal Blade on Ricky. I mean, this is now going to allow him to have the potential of getting solo kills on some of the backline as a Secret.
Yeah, it's also just a ton of damage output during Tricks of the Trade. They need to be able to kill the Dazzle very early on so the Lifestealer can latch on to targets very early. Even preventing the Wii from being cast will help Lifestealer a lot in the long run.
Here we have Empire. We need to smoke up and go for some action. Miposhka, he's got Ramzes inside him. See if they can catch out from Secret. Arteezy, the only one to reveal himself at the moment on the bottom lane on his PL. And he's playing it safe, backing off. And they are just going to wait, of course, for the completed Deso to come out to Ramzes. So something that may catch out the side of Secret if they get a good jump onto them Empire. Now, Arteezy, it's all about how far he dares to come down on this top lane. He's playing it safe for the moment. You know, Secret realizing that Empire entirely off the map, and the Arteezy, he's back behind the tier 3s. They're not going to let themselves get caught out by this move.
Yeah, he has a haste rune, but yeah, knowing that they can just easily kill him with a DK stun. Like, at this point, you aren't really sure if DK has a blink, has a shadow blade. He did recently complete BKB, but no signs of any other items, so they have to play like he could have one of those items.
Oh, look at this Secret with the wraparound. They want to punish this push here. They have got the Ravage available, Universe. He can get himself into position. He will jump in. He's just going to blow the Ravage onto Scanlan. They can remove the DK from the fight. They'll have a good chance of turning this. But Ramzes jumping in. They'll drop down the Zadish of the Swamp from Pilot. Will be there with the epicenter from Afterlife ripping through them. They've lost Pi. They've lost two. They're going to lose Envy as well here. By the looks of it, is Empire taking 3 kills. Scanlan, he's still alive in this one with the armor totaling. Turns around the Forest Strike onto Arteezy. Triple kill for Ramzes. And Secret getting absolutely destroyed there off the back of what was a movement and an initiation that they were looking for themselves. Jumping in, blowing that solo Ravage, but Empire, they were there to instantly react to that play.
Universe did not think it was going to be a solo Ravage. I think he expected at least 2 heroes to be behind him, especially with no blink on the Lifestealer, no blink on the Disruptor. You'd think that the supports would be much closer to the DK, but Empire were just out of Ravage range, but close enough to immediately follow up. That was a sick epicenter by Afterlife.
Jumping in here. Does have Puppy to back him up if he gets in too much trouble. Now we're going to see some Highlight Eye come in, but is still he getting glimpsed back? Ramzes, he goes in. He says, I want to kill you, Puppy. But now he's just got a raging TP, just taunting the Dazzle. The rest of Empire, Scandal, King R should be fine, and he will. They'll get themselves out. So again, serious damage being done here to the base of Secret. And just not an answer for it at the moment from the guys. Arteezy, he's picked up the Yasha, headed straight up towards that top lane to continue to farm. But as we can see individually, just the 3 cores on the side of Empire, straight up all ahead of the 3 cores of the respective side of Secret.
And Arteezy is playing the Phantom Lancer very defensively, very passively. It wasn't that great of a laning phase for him, but he has not been able to make any aggressive maneuvers. He's just purely farming, and even his early Diffusal Blade pick. He went Diffusal Blade before the BOTs, yet he still used no charges on that.
We are going to see Venge, Pipe, grab themselves the Vladimir. So something else to offer to the fights, the Secret they have been looking for. We have seen each and every time that Universe has this Ravage, they will look to aggressively smoke and, or at least react to the pushes of Empire and try and catch them off on the sidelines.
Their catch is just terrible though. Maybe like it's someone gets swapped in or PL keeps chasing them down, but none of that has really happened for Secret. They can't even get the kill off the first Ravage, let alone second, third, fourth.
And Ramzes just continue to be an absolute beast. Of course, Hyperstone on top of the Deso, Armlet, Echo Saber. Lifestealer certainly having a very good game at the moment, 26 minutes in. And as you said, already kind of draft versus draft, the Lifestealer is very good against some of the heroes of the side of Secret, and we're certainly seeing that in the fight.
So both teams kind of know what each team is up to. Empire using a scan, you know, Dire Secret Shop, that pinged red, and then Secret also caught a glimpse of Lifestealer hopping into someone. They didn't have a sentry ward there, but they know he's inside the Riki.
Now we're going to see this again. They have the Ravage, but they've got to be careful.
They have BKB on Gyrocopter. This is big.
Envy? Kind of toying with Scandal, trying to get him to go in. You can see from the sidelines by Poshka, he's got Ramzes inside of him, ready for a jump onto a backliner. But yeah, as you said, it's going to be that, a little bit harder to just dispatch of Envy immediately with the BKB. And it looks like Empire, though, they'll spot it out. They realize that they can't really go too aggressive. Just respecting the jump that Secret can get on them.
They're very hesitant because of the BKB.
Yeah.
Even if the BKB were down, though, Vengeful Spear could defensively swap them, or a Grave could come out, so even that's not a guaranteed kill without it. So who do they want to jump right now? I guess Tidehunter would be pretty good. I don't think they can prevent the Ravage, though, because of the two supports. So
yeah, and the fact that he's got the Force as well. I mean, he's got the potential to reposition himself. Get a chance to Ravage, Puppy. It's going to pick up the gem for the team so they can start to get a bit more map control. And of course, just to help deal with this Riki, Naposhka, who's currently, you know, just constantly trying to jump in on the back lines with Ramzes inside him.
And PL's just not able to split push at this point. Constantly worried about an Infest Bomb, even an Epicenter. Burrow Strike combo from Sand King with three or four illusions out would probably kill him. And Sand King looks like he's going for a four step once he gets a Veil or Aether Lens, let's say. It's going to be incredible damage output from them, and PL never wants to go BKB.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, yeah, just Afterlife with the items that he's got already, just having the Aghanims. You know, they talked about in the structure how much it can do against the PL and his army. So, you know, Secret, they have to be careful about that. And the thing is, well, what have they got to kind of stop Afterlife from getting away with it? He's never really going to be on the front. He's always going to be on the back. So, Secret, unless they're able to kind of smoke up and get behind, get rid of the Sand King first, it's going to be very hard to deal with Empire in these team fights. They do now have the Greaves on Universe. So, a bit of a step up there in team fight potential. And Secret, they are smoked up. Empire are going to look for Roche. We'll see what kind of a jump Secret can get Maposhka. He's going to wander around, but Puppy. Should have eyes on this. Indeed, they have. They're jumping straight away with the Ravage. It will tickle Ramzes onto the sidelines, and Envy's popped his BKB. Secret maybe seeing if they can chase down for more. It's only been Maposhka so far to feel the wrath of this smoke. Empire, still with four very strong heroes on the sidelines, you know, Epicenter and everything else. And Maposhka, he's going to just straight up buy back into the game, just wanting to leave no chance of Secret looking for the Roshan. But I mean, without the Ravage and the fact that Empire still have all their ults up. Yeah, Secret just realized they've just left the pit entirely. They know that they're going to have a huge amount of difficulty trying to contest this rush.
The Empire are excellent, kind of all committing to a fight, but not all getting caught out in a Ravage, as opposed to Mineski, who I think, like, they always wanted to fight together, but they were just way too close together and could never just leave one hero to die, like Empire has done that last fight. Well, that's a free rush for them. One thing that Envy is not really doing is scouting too much with his ogre or stacking. He wing the ogre around him for frost armor.
I'm just gonna have a quick pause here, but I mean, let's just talk about kind of the overview of this game so far, Ben. With 30 minutes in, 12 for 8, you know, you do have Ramzes now, 14,000 net worth. He's a couple of thousand ahead clear of the PL and the Gyro. It's just Secret at this point. How do you turn this one around? Have you just got to kind of wait for Empire to try and go for the high ground and catch them off there, you know, with a good swap repositioning one of Empire's cores? I mean, how can you just even begin to comprehend tackling Empire when they have this just great positioning each and every time, which is making it pretty much impossible for Universe to hit the ravages that he needs?
You kill Sand King. If you can, I think if you trade like Tidehunter for Sand King, the PL can go crazy in the fights.
And a free courier for Ramzes. Oh, he takes the courier, he'll take a tier 3 as well. Easy couple of objectives here for the man, and now Universe will jump in, but Ramzes raging away. Jumping at him, forcing back the Tidehunter, getting a bit of damage done onto the racks. Now Scandal coming in as well with the Dragon Tail. Universe has got to be careful, trying to get himself back, but the glimpse is there, the swap from Pi, and the Shallow Grip from Puppy will keep him alive on the sidelines. Burrow Strike onto Envy and Maposhka, starting to jump away with the tricks of the trade. Envy gets the BKB out, tries to escape, now turning onto Ramzes, but Ramzes tries to go in aggressively. They will be able to pop the Aegis here, Secret. Can they kill the Lifestealer a second time? They're going to certainly go for it, moving straight in onto the man. Ramzes actually falling low. The clouds be there, but there we have Epicenter coming in! Afterlife just trashing the side! Envy's down, Arteezy will be Shadow Grave up. He gets glimpsed back in, trying to get away with the double ganger, but the Breathe Fire from Scandal, two dead on the side of Secret, and Empire, no mercy, moving in for more eyes onto Puppy. He'll go down as well. There's gonna be four dead on Secret, no buybacks available. Ben, Secret getting entirely outplayed this game by Empire.
Yeah, I thought Lifestealer had made a mistake by raging right before his Aegis
and
popped.
And GG is called. Look at that. Empire absolutely over the moon with this best of one victory. And Ben, Secret coming into this tournament. I think it's an understatement to say that people expected a lot more from them, but this just was... What went wrong, Ben?
The Sand King was the ace up Empire's sleeve. It countered the PL, it countered all their team fight, too much spread damage for Dazzle.